Good morning. Welcome back to our lecture room. And we are in part 2 of our discussion on encroachment. Our topic will be Relocation Survey, the effective method to determine encroachment and overlapping of boundaries. Thank you nga pala sa aking mga kaibigan sa Rocky's Barbershop dyan sa SM Lanang, kay Jumar, kay Bambi, Melvin, Ray, and si Noel. Thank you for subscribing. And if you guys want to subscribe, please hit the subscription button and also the notification bell for future updates. We will continue after this short intro. So let's proceed. Let us assume that you are going to purchase a property in this crowded area. Now, you want to purchase here, no? Sa may red circle na ito. So there is a need to determine the meets and bounds of the properties to determine if there is an encroachment on the property rights. Yung pag-usapan natin na yung overhanging trees, overhanging leaves, and the encroachment also on the property itself. Kasi nga, dikit-dikit, no? Ang area. So, before you buy, you have to conduct a relocation survey to determine possible encroachment on the property and or overlapping boundaries. Okay, what is relocation survey? Yan po ang ating dapat pag-usapan una bago ang encroachment. So, relocation survey is a method of determining the precise identification of an established land, its corners, and the limits or boundaries. And ginagamit nilang surveying tool ito. Ang tawag po nito is theodolite. Yan. Theodolite ang tawag dito. And maraming mga advanced na mga klaseng surveying tool na ginagamit ng mga geodetic engineers. But it serves this purpose of measuring the distance, the meet and bounds of a tract of land. And what is the purpose of a relocation surveys? Okay. The main purpose of this kind of survey is to reestablish the boundaries of a tract of land wherein a previous survey has already been undertaken and to verify if the existing location of the property overlaps adjoining lots. So, ganito po yan. Ang purpose is to reestablish or i-recheck ang boundary ng isang lupa na meron ng dating survey. Kasi kailangan may dating survey para may basis sila i-recheck or i-reestablish. Kasi kung walang dating survey, eh, magkakandak pa ng first survey. Okay, so remember, there was a previous survey already as a basis to recheck or to reestablish the boundaries of that particular tract of land. And the purpose is to verify if the existing location of the property is still intact or baka naka-overlap na ito sa adjoining lots. Kaya nga, kapag matapos ang relocation survey and masabi ninyo, meron pa ba yung markers natin or yung mga mohon? Eh, hindi na makita. Ma'am, sir, sabihin ng geodetic engineer, sir, palagyan ko po ng mohon or marker. And they will do that, no? That is part of their job. So, example of ang mohon dito sa Pilipinas, ito. PS means private survey. Made of cement po yan siya, pabilog, mahaba yan siya, ibinabaon yan sa lupa. And sa United States po, as an example or comparison only, ganun ang marker nila, pero it's quite better than us. But okay lang, they are actually a first world country, third world country tayo, pero humahabol na rin tayo later on sa technology nila. No? But I would like to emphasize here na maganda sa marker nila is naka-establish here na nakaukit dito is 250 fine or imprisonment per disturbing this marker. So, ang tanong is, sa atin bang Philippine setting, meron bang penalty for disturbing our monument, marker, or mohon? Kasi marami pong tumatanggal ng mga mohon, nililipat ang mohon para lumaki ang area nila. And if they do that, meron po bang penalty under the law? And the answer is yes, under Article 313 of the Revised Penal Code, as amended by Republic Act 10951. There is a fine not exceeding 20,000 pesos imprisonment of 1 to 30 days, arrest to minor, or both. Eh sabihin nyo, ah sir, arrest to minor man lang yan, attorney. Maliit lang yan, kayang-kaya yan. Pwede nga kami maka-apply ng probation. Okay, that's correct. However, remember that when you are convicted with this kind of a penalty, you will be considered as a criminal felon and you will have a criminal record. The moment you commit any other criminal infractions under the revised penal code, eh, hindi na kayo maka-apply ng probation. So mag-ingat po kayo, huwag nyo itong basta-bastahin ito. Alright, let us proceed. And the question is, who conducts a relocation survey? Under the Philippine Geodetic Engineering Act of 1998, Republic Act Number 8560, only geodetic engineers licensed, ha? Take note, licensed by the Professional Regulations Commission may conduct land surveys. Marami silang pwedeng gawin, no? Subdivision survey. Tapos nila ma-subdivide, pwede nila i-consolidate. Consolidation survey, land development survey, GPS control survey, among many other things. Ang atin ngayon is relocation survey. Bakit? Because we would like to know what is encroachment. Yan. So ano bang encroachment? It is a situation in a real estate when another property owner intrudes, no, upon the property rights or property of his neighbor. So may intrusion on the property rights, the property's neighbor by building or extending a structure to his neighbor's land or property unintentionally, meaning to say good faith, intentionally, bad faith. So, it includes sowing and planting. Yung maglagay ka ng binhi sa lupa at magplant ka ng mga tanim. Yan po ay tinatawag na encroachment. Importante po, intrusion upon the property rights or property of his neighbor and by extending a building or planting or sowing something. Alright, so let's create a scenario, no? So, here is Jojo and here is Bong. They are neighbors. Ito pong, yan ang wall nila in between their properties. So, they constructed their own houses and they have their own properties placed therein, cars, yan yung dog cage ni Jojo. Tapos, nagtanim din si Jojo ng mga puno, no? Because ang intention niya later on, baka makaharvest ako, eh, kumita din ako. Ganon din kay Bong, gaya-gaya din kasi tayo, no? Kapag kapitbahay, ganyan man na, gaya-gaya system, no? Tanim din siya ng puno. And at the same time, ang ginawa din niya is nagay rin siya ng binhi sa lupa, no? By sowing, no? Sowing ng mga seeds para maging crops ito. Now, if you would like to know what is the difference between sowing and planting, ito po. Sowing is the act of tossing seeds in a controlled manner into the soil in order to initiate their sprouting, yeah, sprouting, into baby plants, no? Pagkatapos niyan, pwede mo nang kunin, tapos i-plant, which is the act of taking a plant already established with roots, stem, and leaves, digging a hole, then place its roots into the hole, then takpan ulit ng lupa. So, mga plantita-plantita, intindihan po natin yan, especially in pandemic, maraming naging plantito and plantita. Tanim muna tayo ng binhi, tapos later on, ililipat natin. Sowing, then planting. Alright, they are good friends, no? They play basketball together, they talk, and syempre, good neighbors they are. But, unknown to them, they have a problem. Ang actual boundary pala nila is itong red marker na yan. Hindi nila alam yan. Hindi nila alam yan. Yan ang boundary nila. And they continue to coexist peacefully because without knowledge of that problem. Until such time na si Jojo, eh, gusto niya niyang ibenta property. And he offered it for sale. Of course, sabi niya, Bong, baka gusto mong bilhin. Sabi niya, Bong, ay, wala akong pera para. O sige, offer ko for sale kasi lipat na ako sa ibang lugar eh. Alright, ngayon, ikaw yung buyer. Yes, you. So, what will you do as part of due diligence is to hire a geodetic engineer and conduct relocation survey para ma-determine nga yung meets and bounds. Yan ang tama na gagawin. And there, the result is nakita natin na meron encroachment on the part of Bong sa property ni Jojo. So, yun ang nangyari dyan. So, Jojo approached Bong and told Bong about the encroachment, and that started the sour relationship between the two. Okay? Kasi medyo pangit kasi yung term na encroachment, the word, no? So, depende kasi sa pag-usap sana ni Jojo, pagsabi sa kanya, and para ma-establish yung relationship. Pwede na pag-usapan na, pare, medyo mang boundary pa na natin, may problema, baka pwede natin ayusin. Mga ganun ba? Pero if you say, pare, naka-encroach ka, away talaga yan. Kasi parang you're accusing somebody of stealing or doing something wrong. Diba? Alright, if you are the buyer of that property, it will define what kind of buyer are you. Pag mag-back out ka, then you are the typical buyer na ayaw ng problema. But if you're a risk taker, okay, I will buy this one so that I could negotiate from Jojo a very the lower amount, and later on I'll just talk to Bong about the encroachment problem. And by that, mas makatipid ako o kumita ako dahil liliit ang value ng property na bibilihin ko. Now, actually, that would depend now on how did Bong encroach on the property of Jojo. Okay? If you are the owner, or si Jojo for that matter, kung hindi mo binili, it would depend upon the good faith on the part of Bong or bad faith. Yan lang naman talaga eh. Kasi kung sinadya niya o hindi niya sinadya. Inosente siya o may kasalanan siya. Ganun lang po. Okay, ano po ang basis natin? Of course, we seek refuge under the Civil Code of the Philippines, and it is under Article 448 to 456. Okay. Sabi nga natin, pag-usapan lang natin dito is ang good faith or bad faith. Alright. Now, take note that under the law, the builder, sower, or planter who plants, sow, or build on another's property is presumed to be in good faith. Kasi the rule of thumb is that presumption of good faith. Yan. Now, if Jojo would say to Bong, Bong, you are in bad faith, Jojo must prove with clear and convincing evidence that actually Bong is in bad faith. Kasi nga, ang presumption is that Bong is in good faith. So, under the law, Jojo has to prove that he is in bad faith. You got any proof? Yan, sabi pa sa karakter natin. And you know, the kind of proof needed is clear and convincing evidence po. Okay. Alam mo, we often hear good faith and bad faith in almost in human interactions, no? Kapag, alam mo, yung nangyari, hindi ko man kasi alam yun, inosente ako, I'm in good faith. Ah. Yan may usual. Or, sabihin natin, ay, yung tao na yan, masama talaga yan siya, yung ginawa talaga, sinadya niya yan, because he is in bad faith, no? Usually, yan ang ginagamit natin ng mga terms, no? And take note that good faith and bad faith are also present in property dispute. Like this one, itong encroachment. Being in good faith means the difference of being reimbursed of what you have constructed, built, planted, or sowed, or being liable for damage. So, importante po na in good faith ka, no? So, sabi nga ng Supreme Court, which I will read, the Supreme Court in many occasions have defined builder in good faith under Article 448 of the Civil Code as one who, not being the owner of the land, builds on that land, believing himself to be its owner, and unaware of the defect in his or her title or mode of acquisition. Okay. The essence of good faith lies in an honest belief in the validity of one's right, ignorance of a superior claim, and absence of intention to overreach another. That is the case of spouses Aquino versus spouses Aguilar, GR number 182754, June 29, 2015. So, it must be noted that good faith is presumed and bad faith should be established by clear and convincing evidence. Bad faith is not simply bad judgment. Hindi lang yun bad judgment, ha? Or negligence. Or nagkamali lang, ha? Hindi yun. It must imply a dishonest purpose or conscious doing of a wrong, usually partaking the nature of fraud. Parang nanglalamang, nangloloko ka talaga. Gusto mo makalamang. gusto mong palakihin ang area mo, gusto mong makabenefit na hindi naman yun sa'yo. Alright? Marami pong nangyayari niyan sa atin ngayon. And we do that, and the problem is that we do not even ask permission na lang sana kahit na magtanim naman tayo ng gulay sa backyard ng ating neighbors. Alright? So, let's proceed. Now, let us assume here that Bong is in good faith. Pag-usapan natin, kasi ano ba naman yung mga rights and remedies ni Jojo, the landowner, or ikaw, kung ikaw nakabili, under the law, if good faith. Okay, number one. Number one option is that all bills sown and planted may be appropriated by the landowner as his own. So, pwedeng kunin ni Jojo lahat ng nakatanim, lahat ng na-construct doon sa property na yan, doon sa ka-encroach area, doon sa property line niya. Pero, kailangan niya bayaran si Bong, yung builder, sower, or planter. Bakit? Kasi in good faith nga si Bong. Hindi naman niya kasalanan. Hindi rin niya alam. Inosente siya. Alright. Or second option is that i-oblige niya si Bong na, sige Bong, bilihin mo na lang ang property na na-encroach mo. So the builder and planter to pay the price of the land, but he cannot be obliged to buy the land if its value is more than the value of the building of the tree. Sabi niya, Bong, bilihin mo na lang. Okay, sige, tingnan natin magkano ang presyo. So, in-appraise. E pag-appraise, ang value ng land versus doon sa value nung na, let's for example, itong construction nila ng garage, tapos itong mga crops at saka trees, mas malaki ang value ng land. Hindi mo mapilit si Bong because Bong is in good faith. So, ibig sabihin, kung ayaw niya, magbayad na lang siya ng rent. Pero kung gusto niya, kahit na malaki ang value ng land para lumawak din yung area niya, pwede rin. No problem. Pwede namang napag-uusapan. Pero the law says, he cannot be obliged if the value of the land is more than the value of the building or trees. Pero kung what example is that puro crops lang or yung mga things lang na sinow niya, is that wala siyang option na pwede niyang bilhin, but kung hindi, bayad lang talaga siya ng rent kay Jojo or sa landowner. Okay? Now, if they cannot agree to the terms and conditions, siyempre, they have to talk about magkanong amount, magpaanong bayaran, or sa rent ba, magkanong amount ng rent, and the court will fix the terms, no? They have to go to court and ask the court on how to fix the terms. So, yun po ang situation kapag in good faith. Alright, let us say if Bong is in bad faith. Ayan. Demonyo, nakatutok na sa kanya. So, what are the remedies of Jojo or the landowner in this situation? All built and sown and planted may be appropriated by the landowner as his own. Akin lahat ng tinanim, sow, or constructed on that area, and no indemnity. No. Hindi kita pwede bigyan. Hindi kita pwede makahingi ng pera. Unlike doon sa start, yung good faith is that meron siyang indemnity, no? Here, because you are in bad faith, kunin ko yan, wala. Wala kang matatanggap. Plus, you must pay me damages too. Yan. Another option would be to compel the builder and planter to pay the price of the land. Wala na yung value kung more than o hindi. Basta bilhin mo na yan. Ayoko na yan. He has to pay. And the sower to pay the proper rent. Wala siyang option to buy, no? And to pay damages. Eh, paano ko sabihin nung ni Bong, wala akong pera eh, kasi hindi ko naman din, wala talaga akong pera. So, meron pang first option. Or, pwede ring the third option. Demand, no? Ito, mabigat. From the builder, the demolition of the building. I-demolish mo yung party wall na yan, ikaw nagtayo. I-demolish mo yung encroachment ng extension mo. Bunutin mo lahat yung mga crops at mga tanim mo. And you have to replace things in their former condition at your expense. Ikaw lahat gumastos, balik mo yan. Plus, meron kang babayaran na daños perjuicio sa akin or damages. Take note that in all these three options, no, options po ito, there is always the payment of damages by the person who built, sown, and planted in bad faith. Okay. So, This is an actual scenario, no? I will exit for a while so that ma-clear natin. Now, if you'll notice here, the property of Mr. A is here. And the property of Mr. B is here. And the property of Mr. C is here. Actually, ang kanilang boundary is itong brown. Yan ang kanilang property line na boundary nila from the property of Mr. X. No? However, si property A, naka-encroach siya ng about 16 square meters, nakapasok siya, lampas doon sa property line. Whereas si Mr. B, naka-encroach siya ng about 60 square meters dito. Pasok siya sa property line. Si Mr. C naman, nakapasok siya dito for about 120 square meters. So, lahat silang tatlo, puro may mga encroachment sa property ni X. Now, to determine their liabilities or obligations, yun, pasok din tayo sa good faith or bad faith rule. So, kung good faith sila, then we follow the good faith rule under the civil code. Kung bad faith, then the bad faith rule under the civil code. Now, take note that itong blue line na ito, there is an existing concrete wall. Now, if you ask me, this is a very important piece of thing or evidence to discuss and establish who built this wall so that we will understand whether or not Mr. A, B, C were in good faith or in bad faith. Yan, one of the pieces of evidence needed. Alright? So, ito ang mga examples ng mga encroachments na nakita ko sa internet. No? Ito, encroachment, chimney niya, nandito naka-encroach sa kabilang bahay. Ito, naka-encroach talaga sa harapan ng bahay. Ito, sa harapan ng bahay. Ito, sa property line itself. So, these are kind of being problematic encroachments na pwedeng simula ng kaguluhan. Okay? So, with that, I would like to say a parting word that in property encroachments, the importance of being in good faith makes the difference between having the right to be reimbursed or being liable for damages. Take note of that. So, thank you. Shukran, danke. I'll see you soon during our next video lecture. Lamat!